Some key things to keep in mind when making test question discriminations between response and stimulus generalization. With stimulus generalization, what you're gonna be looking for is more than one stimulus evoking the same one response. So imagine this, you've been taught to say tree when you see a palm tree, and you've mastered that label. And then one day you see an oak tree. It has some similarities with the palm tree, but it's different, and yet you still independently, without training, correctly call the oak tree a tree. This is stimulus generalization, and it can go farther than that. You could see a pine tree, and again, without training correctly, you called that pine tree a tree. Three different yet similar trees or stimuli that evoke the same one response. And we could take this analogy even further to every type of tree in the universe, all of which can be labeled correctly as tree. Stimulus generalization has no bounds. Now, on the other side of this, we've got response generalization. Here, we're gonna have more responses in the presence of one stimulus, or SD. So you see a palm tree and you say palm tree, but sometimes when you see a palm tree, you correctly label it as a phytelephantoid or ceroxyloid or araucasia. And even if you mispronounce these alternative names for a palm tree, you're still exhibiting response generalization. One other helpful detail, think of the stimulus as an antecedent that evokes behavior. So stimulus generalization would mean more than one stimulus evokes the same one behavior. Now think of a response as a behavior, so response generalization would be one antecedent stimulus evokes more than one response or behavior. Aren't you glad you're not studying to be a board certified dendrologist? That's the scientific study of trees and other woody plants. I wonder what their pass rate is.